Hey guys, it's Bananaowns here bringing you episode 2 of this Tet's Play of Rayman Origins, and a little bit of a longer episode here. A lot of stuff to talk about again. It's been a really long time since I've been recording videos, and of course I've been uploading stuff almost every single day. And basically, you know, it's been pretty cool. And so Rayman Origins, I haven't played a lot of this game yet. I'm going to talk about Pokemon during this episode. So basically, Rayman Origins, I've been playing this pretty, it's pretty fun. A very great art style, actually. I've been really, really happy playing this game. It looks very beautiful and colorful. As of right now, since it's been a long time since I've talked about what I've been playing, Grand Theft Auto 5 has been taking up a lot of my time. I've managed to 100% the single player. I've been playing a lot of GTA Online. That'll take a little bit longer to 100% for achievements-wise, but I've been really enjoying playing it. It's a little bit of grind. It's definitely only fun with friends. And basically, it's fun, and I expect a few videos to come out of that once I get some ideas to do. I don't want to saturate my smart. I want to make a good video of those before I really do anything. So other things I've been playing, definitely before I go into Pokemon X and Y, I'm gonna talk about something just had released today. So October 22nd, of course, I think Batman released today. I haven't gotten that yet. Maybe a little bit later. But I got the full burst DLC for the Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 3, and if you know, I'm a really big fan. I do a lot of videos and stuff in that. So basically, that DLC is an extra story mission, so it's a boss battle, some revamped cutscenes. I don't know if the revamped cutscenes are in the physical DLC or the retail copy. So they kind of took a page out of the Capcom Street Fighter handbook, and basically is they released a $40, you know, cheaper version of the new cutscene, like the remastered cutscenes and the new DLC, and then the retail version also gets a like 37 or so costumes, which is, considering it's for $40 and you get the base game, which is probably like 20, and the $10 DLC, and it's actually a pretty good deal if you definitely haven't played that game yet. Now, if you already have the game, not worth it at all to get the full retail. Just get the $10 DLC, and then even I would say I'm a really big fan of the Ninja Storm series, but this DLC, this Kabuto one, hopefully it'll go on sale relatively soon, because at $10 right now, what you get is the new Sage Mode Kabuto character, who's pretty good. You get a story mission with some cool cutscenes and stuff, it's pretty cool, and you get 100 like challenge missions. Now these challenge missions remind me a lot of the Tower of Lost Souls from Soul Calibur 5, Soul Calibur 4, yeah, Soul Calibur 4, there we go, from Soul Calibur 4. Now the Tower of Souls from Soul Calibur 4 was like increasing waves of, well, not waves in a sense, increasing levels of difficulty, so like you had to fight a match with certain criteria, like won't let you block or like the enemies do twice as much damage, so it's kind of like that. And so far, it's been pretty easy. I'm 40 missions in out of 100, and of course you get an achievement for doing them all. And yeah, you know, I love my achievements, especially Ninja Storm achievements. I have all the achievements in the Ninja Storm game so far, but I just have to work on 100%ing this DLC, which is pretty easy. So it's, the achievements for this DLC are like S ranking the Kabuto mission, beating the Kabuto mission, getting 10 images, which is directly related to the missions, and then finishing 50 missions and then finishing 100 missions. So it's basically finish all the missions, do the bonus criteria for 10 of them, and then do the Kabuto stuff. So it's not too bad. I'll probably have these missions done before the weekend's over, and because they don't take a long time to do. I know it just came out today, and I played for maybe a couple hours, and I got 40 missions done. So definitely not going to take a really long time for those. So that's Naruto, and then now to the big thing is Pokemon X and Y. Now, I didn't originally think I was going to get to play this game. I don't own a 3DS, but I was really lucky because my sister owns one, and then she wasn't really playing it, so she let me borrow it. So I'm currently borrowing that right now so I can play Pokemon X. So I got X. It's been pretty great so far. I'm very happy with it. A lot easier game than the other ones, but I guess it's come some design choices that they made. But it's overall very fun. I really like those easier design choices that they made. A little bit of pacing issues, I would say, in between certain gyms, like between the first and the second gym. You're maybe playing for like a few hours before you even get to the second gym. And then again, some design choices. So you get your new starter, and then like an hour later when you reach the main city, that's kind of like Paris, you get to pick one of the original Pokemon starters, which is pretty cool considering like you can plan it out. So also the Nintendo is offering an event, Torchic, right now that you can Mega Evolve into a Mega Blaziken once you have it fully evolved, which is pretty cool. So basically, if you plan it right, you can choose either a water or a grass for either of them. So like you can say pick a Froakie, the water starter from the first one, and then from the Kanto starters, you can pick Bulbasaur, so then you can pick Torchic, so you can have fire, water, and grass right away. That's really cool because it's really easy. And then in relation to like having different types, I would say this Pokemon game has the most Pokemon available at the beginning of the game. Like, you can get a really good rounded team by the first forest that you go into. The first forest has those three elemental monkeys, the Panseer, Pansage, and Panpour. So you can catch one of those. It also has a Pikachu you can get, and, you know, some bug Pokemon, of course. But basically, like, I spent a lot of time just catching Pokemon in the very beginning and getting a good team. And then another item you get, like, right after the first gym is the experience chair. Now, the experience chair is a key item now, and instead of just divvying up the experience, what it is is you have your lead Pokemon, you have your experience chair on, and then lead Pokemon gets full experience, and then all the rest of Pokemon in the party automatically get 50% of that experience. So what that means is, since you get it so early on, and if you leave it on, is that you don't have to really grind out Pokemon levels anymore. If you just train normally, if you just by battling normal trainers and stuff like that, what happens is your Pokemon all are around the same level. Of course, if you have like a favorite or something, they're going to be a little bit higher, but it's really great because they're all around the same area, and they're on the same level, and I've never liked grinding in Pokemon games, especially just going through trying to beat the Elite Four. It's tedious, it takes a long time to do, especially if you want to have a good, well-rounded party of six and really have that going. So in the past Pokemon games, I have pretty much just blazed through with my starter, which, you know, it's not the best thing to do, especially since I'm not too competitive a Pokemon player, but I like playing with like friends and competitively, like EVs and stuff like that. So, you know, it's not fun just using a starter for the whole game pretty much. So in this regard, so I was able to basically get six Pokemon from the very beginning, and I really enjoyed it. So I'm pulling up my sister's 3DS right now. Yeah, so I've been doing a lot of breeding lately. I've already beaten the Elite Four by now and all that stuff. So right now I'm basically doing the end game and starting to train up for the metagame. And basically the metagame is still evolving right now, especially with the new Pokemon, and the Pokemon bank isn't up until December, which means so you can't get those Pokemon from past generations that are on your white or white 2 save or something like that. You can't really get them yet, and that's kind of a bit of a pain in the ass, but this is the first time I've really been raising Pokemon by hand. Sad to say, like, as in I mean like battle Pokemon by hand. Usually I use a Pokesave in order to make a Pokemon, definitely with like legit IVs and stuff like that. Definitely not like a Magikarp or Flamethrower, but usually just to do that really quickly because it takes a really long time in order to do it yourself. So this is my first time I've really been experiencing with like breeding and stuff, like trying to get perfect natures for breeding, hidden abilities, haven't been really going into the egg moves yet because Cerebi.net, they're still really upgrading a lot of that stuff, so there's still a lot to be figured out. And so I've basically been just breeding stuff, and it's been really cool, especially there's new Friend Safari now. So Friend Safari is like the Safari Zone. You can use your own Pokemon and your own Pokeballs, but you can find Pokemon that aren't really normally available in the region. It's just every one of your friends has a different Safari Zone, so they give you an incentive to basically keep playing in order to keep adding more friend codes and stuff like that. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, so let's see, my first party that I used in this game, I had a Simisage, which is the green grass monkey, that funky monkey, so I couldn't resist. I used a Lucario that you get from another trainer, which is pretty great. This Lucario can make it evolve, and it quickly became a mainstay. There I got a Blastoise, which is the Squirtle I got. I got a Raichu from Pikachu in the very beginning. I got a Delphox, which is the fully evolved form of the Firestarter. I didn't use the Torchic because I had a friend that got Froakie, so I wanted a Delphox so we could trade. I could trade him a Fennekin. And then I got a Talonflame, which is a really cool bird fire Pokemon. I really enjoy it. And so basically what I've been doing now is I'm trying to raise another team right now, so I'm trying to get a full Greninja up. And so Greninja has a hidden ability called Protean, which lets it change its attack to remove use, and it's freaking OP and it's pretty fast, and I'm really excited to get to use that. And basically been training some stuff. I want to get an Arcanine, have some Growlithe that perfect, that have the good nature and decent IVs right now. So, and then the new Honedge, which is like the sword ones, look pretty cool. Again, so I'm trying to raise one of those, and I want to try and raise just a bunch of them. I'm trying to just test the waters right now while I can before things get too serious. And okay, that about wraps up this one, guys. So I will see you in the next one, and probably we'll talk about more Pokemon.